So why is it nice to be able to diagonalize a matrix A? Well, let's think about this. We always talk about how a matrix represents a linear transformation, and the matrix vector multiply is really the application of the linear transformation to that matrix. Now, evaluating linear transformation can be messy. Casting that in terms of a matrix vector multiply is more convenient. But let's have a look at what we can do here. If we have a matrix A, and we apply it to our vector V, then we end up with a vector W. A maps the vector V to W. Now here V really is the vector of coefficients that tell us how to take linear combinations of the standard basis vectors. And similarly, W is really the vector of coefficients that tell us in the same basis how to take linear combinations of those basis vectors to come up with our vector. But that's only one basis in which to view these vectors. Alternatively, we can say, well, what if we take our vector V, and what if we write it as a linear combination of these columns of our matrix X? Okay. A more convenient way of writing that is to say, oh, we can write it as X times V tilde. Right? Where V tilde is just a vector with these coefficients as its elements. Okay? Now, how do we get these coefficients from our vector V? Well, we notice that we can always write an X times X inverse right there. And then all that we have done is insert an identity. So this right here is actually our vector V tilde. So what does that really mean? All we've done here is we've replaced V with X times V tilde, where we now in V tilde have the coefficients in terms of this basis that we get from the columns of our matrix X. And we can obviously do the exact same thing to W. We can say, let's also view that vector in the same basis. And then this here becomes the vector W tilde. So what do we have now? We have that W tilde, X times W tilde, is equal to A times X V tilde. Okay? Now we can multiply both sides by X inverse, and what we get then is that W tilde is equal to X inverse A times X V tilde. Ah, but if A is diagonalizable, and X is that matrix that diagonalizes, then this here is just our diagonal matrix lambda. And what we notice is that W tilde is equal to lambda times V tilde. Now that's kind of nice. That what that means is that if we just view our vectors in the correct basis, then our matrix A starts acting as if it's a diagonal matrix. And diagonal matrices are just a lot more convenient to multiply with. Where have we seen this before? We saw this before when we talked about the singular valley decomposition and how if you viewed the vector W and the vector V in the right basis, then you ended up with a diagonal matrix that was multiplying. The difference here is that there, the basis that you viewed V in was different from the basis that you viewed W in. When you have a matrix that's diagonalizable, then all of a sudden you can view both in the same basis, and the operator, the matrix, becomes diagonalizable.